Hello, I'm Joey with Olean's USA. In today's video, we'd like to go over the reasons why you should set your rider sag on your HD bagger, and then how to properly perform this. The tools that will be needed are a motorcycle lift, your spanner slash peg tool that came with your shocks, a sticker, and a tape measure. For the tape measure, we prefer one that uses millimeters, but if you can't find one, there's 25.4 millimeters in an inch if you need to convert. The last thing you'll need is an assistant. This job cannot be performed by yourself. It doesn't matter what motorcycle you're riding. Setting the sag is a critical procedure which should be performed to help optimize your quality of ride. It affects the geometry of the motorcycle, which in turn affects the way the motorcycle handles. It also affects how close you are sitting to the bump rubber. If you're sitting too low into the stroke, you'll be hitting the bump rubber prematurely, which could cause a harsh feeling ride. Generally, we like to see the rider sag to be set at about a third of the full wheel travel of the bike. For an example, your bike has 75 millimeters of wheel travel. We like to see you sitting in about 25 millimeters when you're sitting on the bike. The first step we need to do is get an extended measurement of the rear end of the bike. What we do is we lift the rear end using a motorcycle jack. We basically want to get it just high enough where the rear wheel spins freely. This ensures that we get our true extended measurement. Next, we're going to take our sticker and place it directly above the lower shock mounting point to a fixed location on the fender. The sticker and our lower shock mounting point are going to be our reference points from where we're going to take our measurements. Next, grab your tape measure, take the extended measurement, and record this number. Remove the bike from the bike stand. Sit on it. Ensure that the side stand is up. Now, give the bike a good bounce and let it settle. Get your assistant to measure from the same two reference points that was used in the extended measurement. Record this number. Take this measurement and subtract it from your extended measurement. This is what's going to be your rider sag number. Generally on the HD baggers, we like to see you sitting in about 25 to 30 millimeters. If your number is greater than 25 to 30 millimeters, it means you're sitting too low in the stroke. If this is the case, add preload to each shock to make your rider sag number lower. If your rider sag is less than 25 to 30 millimeters, you're sitting too high into the stroke. In this case, we will remove preload from each shock to make our rider sag number greater. Once your rider sag is set, this will ensure that your bike's geometry is correctly set up. Remember, if you add a passenger or luggage, this will affect your rider sag number. To compensate, you're going to need to add preload to each shock. A good rule of thumb is for every 25 pounds that you add, you're going to want to add one full turn of preload to each shock. For example, a 125-pound passenger will require 5 turns of preload to each shock. It's a good idea to get the weight of the bike off the shocks when you're making large preload adjustments. This concludes our video for setting sag on your HD bagger. We appreciate you watching, and please keep your eyes open for future videos from Olean's USA.